good morning to today's class and let's get started. So today we will look at maths 1. This will be revision lecture and we will look at a small quiz also. So everyone quickly join the quiz link. So you all know the instructions. You need to go to any web browser and type in joinmyquiz.com. Once you're there, then it will ask for a code. Entering the code, you will be directed for your name. And once you enter the name, you will be here on the dashboard. So the code is 194333. That's the code. So everyone, quickly start joining. You need to go to joinmyquiz.com. Once you are there, you have to enter the code, that's 194333. And once you enter the code, it will ask for your name. Enter your name with school name. Okay. Once you join, I can see that you are here. Okay, so Toshif, Rehan, Pish, Pushpa. Others quickly join. We will begin in 30 seconds. Okay, and we will begin in another 20 seconds. Yes, everyone, quickly join. You see the instructions over here? That's joinmyquiz.com. And you need to enter the game code. That's 194333. 194333. That's the code. And here we are going to start. Others, you can join. All right, so that's the first question. Now, what do you mean by simplify? It says simplify as much as possible. Now, simplify means what? You just have to reduce it to lowest form, correct? You just need to reduce it to the lowest form. And how do you reduce? I will give you some hints. So, just check students over here. How do you reduce it to lowest form? Simply, you just write it down like this, 28 over 42, and then you have to reduce it. Like you can cross out by using table of 2, table of 4, table of 7, whichever is convenient, right? Like example, you can go with dividing both the top and bottom with 7, or you can start with 2. For example, if you start with 2, you would get 14, and over here 2 the 4th ones are, so that would be 14 over 21. We can reduce it further by dividing both the top and bottom by 7. So reducing it like that, what will be the answer? You have the choices in front of you. For those who have still not joined, you can still join. 194333 is the code. And which is the correct choice? See, 14 is to 21 is here, but you can still reduce it further. Can reduce it with the table of 7, right? So simplifying further, what do you get? And 47 of you have attempted it already, so I'm going to end the quiz here. Just a minute. Okay, Okay, so students, something went wrong. Please join back again using this code 107411. That's a new code. Please join using this code 107411. That's a new code. Yes, and I can see people are joining here. Okay. 107411, that's the new code. 107411, that's the code. Okay, and let's start. So I guess that should be the first question, should be same. Okay, simplify as much as possible. You already had the answers. Quickly enter the answers. And 54 of you have given the answers. Let's see how many of you got it right. 30 of you have got it right. Still, just check. Some of you have kept the answers 14:21. You have to reduce it further, students. You can reduce it further. So that will be 7. If you go on dividing further with 7, it would be 2:3. Okay, let's look at the next question. In a class of boys and 10 boys and 14 girls, the ratio of girls to boys is, you have to find the ratio of boys to girls, students, okay, and not boys to girls. So first you need to write the number of girls, then the number of boys, okay. So first the number of girls is 14, and then number of boys, that's 10. So next you need to reduce it with the table of 2. What do you get? That will be the answer, okay. So look at the order. It is first the girls and then boys. So girls is 14 and then 10 boys. So 14:10, reduce it with the table of 2, and that will give you the correct answer. Okay, let's see how many of you got it right. 52 of you have answered it. And the correct answer was 7:2. Okay, Nitesh, Akansha, you have got it right. Tantra, good. 23 of you have got it right. Still, some of you have given straight answer 10:14. 10 is boys and 14 is girls. That ratio is wrong. Okay, students. So the correct answer to this was 14 divided by 2. That would give you a 7. 7/5. So the correct answer was 7/5. Okay, 7:5. That was the correct answer. Let's move to next question. And those who are still joining, for them the code is 107411. That's the code. 107411. That's the code. And here you see there is another question from ratio and proportion, from the chapter ratio and proportion. Okay, students, and let's check how to solve this. So I'll just give you it. You just need to cross multiply, right? You just need to cross multiply. So simply by cross multiplying, it would look like this. 2 times 28. So 2 × 28 divided by, should be 2 times 28 equals to C times 7, right? Or 7 times C, like that. You get rid of this C, you get rid of this 7. 7 is in multiplication, right? It is in multiplication, it will move to that side, it will become division. So 2 times 28 divided by 7, that is equals to C. Okay, you can reduce this. 7 times 7, 7 times 4 is 28, right? So what is the value of C? was 8. Okay, the correct answer was 8. Arbaaz Jagravi, Sudhakara, Sakshi, Rajkumar, Nishchay, you all have got it right. 29 of you got it right. Still, some of you have given answers to be 4. Okay, it is not 4. You had to multiply further, right? You had to multiply further. Just check here. This was 2 times 4, isn't it? There was these two numbers in the top. So C equals to 2 times 4, that is 8. 8 was the correct answer to this. Okay. Let's look at next question. Ready, everyone? Please concentrate and try to solve the questions. Don't give random answers. So the next question here is again from the chapter ratio and proportion. Okay, so let's solve it out together first, then you can also try parallelly. Those who know the answers, you can straight away give the answers. So just check, we need to cross multiply 9 times 24. So 9 into 24, that is equals to 36 times x. So 36 times x. Okay, we have to find x. So get rid of 36. 36 on that side would divide, right? So this will be 9 into 24 divided by 36. Okay, students, and now reduce it to lowest form. How could you reduce that to lowest form? 9 ones are 9. 9 times 4 is 36, right? And the remaining part you try it out now. So you are left with 24 over 4, and that would give you the value of x. Further quickly, and 47 of you have answered it. I'm going to end it. Let's see how many of you got it right. The answer to this was 6, isn't it? So we were left with 24 over 4, that was equal to 6. Rajkumar, Nishchay, Sakshi Tiwari, Sakshi Swatantra, you all have got it right. 32 of you got it right. Okay, others, still, if you need some hint, you can always refer to my work, isn't it? Fine, so that's the next question. Again, a question from ratio and proportion. A very simple question, okay? Look at the order, students. Look at the order. That is very important, okay? So, the question is, there are 4 birds and 6 snakes. What is the ratio of birds to snakes? So, first you need to write the number of birds and then the number of snakes. 4 upon 6. But you have to reduce this to lowest form, okay? You have to reduce this to lowest form. We divide both the top and bottom by 2. So that will help you to reduce it to lowest form. Right? Quickly get the answer. Let's check how many of you got it right. 89 participants and more than 50 of you have already answered it. Let's see how many of you got it right. When you are doing the ratio, the order is really important. If you go in the wrong order, your answer is wrong, okay? And we see the top 6 students there. 42 of you got it right. Very good. The correct answer to this was, you just had to reduce it to lowest form. So the correct answer was 2 times 2 is 4 and 2 times 3 is 6. So the correct answer was 2 is to 3, okay? Let's look at the next question. So this is another question from ratio and proportion. We have done around 3 questions of similar type, okay? So this is again a similar question. You just need to cross multiply to find the blank, okay? So simply cross multiplying, that is 3 times 4, which is equals to this box. We don't know what is that box, so box times 12. Get rid of this 12. 12 moves to the other side, it would divide. So 3 times 4 divided by 12 equals to box. Now you can solve it, correct? Just simplify and get the answer quickly. Let's see how many of you got it right. We're still same names on the top. Abdul, the new name, great. 31 of you got it right. All right, the answer was 1. Okay, the answer was 1 to that one. 12 divided by 12, that was 1. Now, look at the next question. This is the simplest question. Nothing can be more simple than this. Okay, just a simple question for you all. What is 43 plus 8? Now, what is 43 plus 8? A simple mental math question in between. And I'll give you another 10 seconds. I'll give you another 10 seconds. You have answered. The correct answer was 51. Okay, adding the numbers, it was a simple question, just a break in between the difficult ones. Okay, so the answer was 64. That's very good that 0 and 1 of you have, only one person has got it right, wrong. Okay, fantastic students. Let's look at the next one. Random selection. Okay, look at the question carefully. It says some number minus 9 is equals to 6. Okay, this is again a simple one, just a mind pressure. So what minus 9 will give you a 6? Which among these is correct? I'll give you another 10 seconds, only 10 seconds. Of you got it right. The correct answer was 15. Okay, so something minus 9 is 6. You just shift the 6, 9 to other side, that would be plus 9. Okay, so 6 plus 9 will give you 15. The correct answer was 15. Okay, fine. Let's move to next one. There can be some questions on mental maths in between. Okay, so that's the next one. Which is the smallest number? Okay, again a very simple question, just to check if all of you are attentive and are not giving random answers. Okay everyone, so just try to give answer as fast as possible for this one. Which is the smallest among these? Okay, and another 5 seconds. 5 seconds and I'm going to stop this question. 66 of you have already answered, and let's check how many of you did it right. The smallest one, which was the smallest one among those? Those are the same names. 62 of you got it right. The smallest one was 11, right? We look at the next question. What is the time? Now, nothing can be more simple than this. So again, just try to answer it as fast as possible. This will help to, shuffle the leaderboard. There are few selected names on the leaderboard. All the names can change if the speed different, right? So everyone, just try to answer it as fast as possible. Yeah, this is the easiest question, right? A small mental math question. So let's see how many of you got it right. Now this is 70 of you have already answered it. Okay, yes, we still see the same names. Great. Very good. The top 6 people who have still maintained their rank. So 62 of you got it right. The answer is correct. It's 5 o'clock. Now, this is again a simple one. What is 5 times 5? Times means what is the operation? What is 5 times 5? Yes, students. What is 5 times 5? Okay, another 5 seconds. want. All right, another 5 seconds. Another 5 seconds. And 70 of you have answered it. Nobody should get it wrong. It was a simple question. 5 times 5, that is 25, right? And the top 6 people, Swatantrata, Sakshi, okay, Shravani, there's a new name, Shravani, Rajkumar, Sakshi, the others' name are same. So 67 of you have got it right, others 1 and 2 people, why so? Please don't give random answers. Let's look at the next one. I think the next would be a question on arranging the numbers. Yes, which of these number series is in ascending or descending order? Okay, I'll give you only 5 more seconds. So try this out really quick. Number series is in ascending or descending order. Don't get it wrong. Okay, look at it carefully. Is it ascending or is it descending? Whichever is the correct one. Okay, it should be either ascending or descending series. All right, and I think you all have got it. 60 of you have answered. Okay, 71, 2 of you have answered it. Let's check how many of you got it right. That was the last question on the quiz. Okay, so some questions we did on ratio and proportion, and then there was few questions. Okay, so ascending and descending order. I think you all just went very fast and got it wrong. Few of you, right? The correct answer was 27, 38, 45, 67. That is the ascending order. And let's see the top 10 students or how many of you got 100 on 100. Third is Sakshi Maurya. Second is Abdul. And first is Swatantrata Sharma. Great. Very good students. So 100%, the students who got 100%, Rajkumar also got 100%, great. And let's look at the top 10 people or students who got 90%. It's Pushpa, Shravani, Sakshi, Amit, Nishchay, Sakshi, again one more name. And just Aman, Harshada, Alisha. Okay, these students got more than 80%. Aman, Sachin, Nilesh, very good students. And please make sure that you really concentrate and look at the question carefully next time, okay? Because reading the question is very important. Reading it correctly, trying to understand what logic you have to apply, like the ascending and descending question was really simple, but you need to focus, right? You need to concentrate on what exactly the numbers are. Fine. So with that, now we will do some questions on linear equation. So as you all know, I will just give you a small info about the paper. So we are doing maths 1, and in maths 1 there are only 2 chapters, right? For the second semester exam, there are only 2 chapters. First is linear equations. Sorry, my pen is not working, it seems. Yeah, so first chapter is linear equations and second chapter is ratio and proportion, right? Linear equation in 2 variables, that is one chapter, and the second one is ratio and proportion. Okay, and from the paper is of 40 marks, right, students? So of course, giving equal weightage to both the chapters, right? Both are of equal weightage, 20 marks, 20 marks. So please make sure that you're preparing both the chapters very well. And it is a very scoring exam because both of the chapters, they are very easy, right? You should practice from the textbook itself. Try to practice from the textbook first, because more than 80% paper will be from the textbook itself, because question number 1, question number 2, question number 3 and question 5, these questions are from textbook itself, isn't it? So if you have referred to the paper pattern, first 3 questions are strictly from the textbook, and question number 4, it will be an application based question, and question number 5 will be a creative question, okay? But still it will be from the textbook. Numbers changed. Question number 4 is application based question, which can be expected out of the textbook. But if you are very thorough with the textual questions, of course you can attempt question number 4 also. So for all those students who are scoring good on the quiz, I think you all can do great on the paper also, and you can score full 40 marks. Okay, just more practice. Fine. So with that, now let us look at this chapter, which is linear equation in two variables. So that's the first question, which is word problem, right? So there are two type of questions which can be expected on linear equation in two variables. One is the equations, where you have the equations already, like this type of question. Just check here, this type of question: solve the following simultaneous equation, or it will just say solve, where equations are already given and you have to solve for x and y. And there is the second type of question, that is these type of questions, where you are given the word problem. You have to frame the equation first and then you have to solve to get x and y. All right, so let's look at few word problems first and then we will look at those equations. Okay, so on this one it says Sanjay gets fixed monthly income every year. There is a certain increment in his salary. After 4 years, his monthly salary was 4,500. And after 10 years, his monthly salary became 5,400. Find his original salary and yearly increment. Always, students, start with whatever is asked. Okay, whatever is asked, you should start with that. So here we are asked to find original salary and yearly increment. So start with setting up variables. Let original salary be X. Okay, so original salary is equals to X, and yearly increment, so there is some yearly increment, that is equals to Y. Okay, so I'm going to make a table out of this. Fine, so the original salary is X. Okay, this is not working, just a minute. Yeah, original salary is X and the yearly increment is Y. Fine, we are given two cases here. One is case one, which will give us the first equation, and other is case two, which will give us the second equation. Okay, so if you draw out tables like this in exam, that is also accepted. All right, and then you don't need to write the statements actually. So here, as per the first condition, just check after 4 years. So yearly increment, if in 1 year you are getting Y increment, for 4 years the increment will be 4Y. Okay, students, for 1 year the increment is Y, then for 4 years, after 4 years the increment will be 4y, because each year it is same. Fine, and then the original salary or the fixed amount is fixed, that is X. And what happens to the total salary? For the first case it is 4,500. Okay, so on a original salary or on the fixed income of X, yearly increment is 4y, for 4 years it is 4y. Okay, yearly it is Y, for 4 years it is 4y. That gives us a total of 4,500. So this gives us the first equation. Okay, row wise we will get equations. So that gives us the first equation X plus 4Y equals to 4,500. And now look, students, how simple it is. You can try out the second one, right? After 10 years, what will be the increment after 10 years? If yearly it is Y, after 10 years it will be how much? After 4 years it was 4Y, after 10 years it will be 10y. The original will remain same, the fixed salary will remain same, that is X. And after 10 years, what is the salary? It's 5,400. Okay, what will be the equation? Look at the row, you get the equation directly. Adding both the increment and salary, we get the total amount. So second equation is X plus 10y, that is equals to 5,400. This is equation 1, this is equation 2. And now we have to solve these two equations to get X and Y, right? So the second part is very easy. You have to solve this. How would you solve? Add or subtract so that the X's will get crossed out. What should we do? We subtract here, right? So just write out the statement. Subtracting 2 from 1, what do we get? So that is x plus 4y equals to 4,500. X plus 10y equals to 5,400. Okay, we are subtracting. So we need to change the signs. This plus will become minus. This plus will become minus. Of course, this will also become minus. Okay, and now solve it. So x minus x will get crossed out. This will be minus 6y, which is equals to 54 minus 45. That is right. So that will be a 9, right? So that would be just 9,000, and give sign of greater number. That will be 9,000 divided by 6. That should be equal to how much, students? Yes. So y equals to negative 9,000 divided by a negative 6. 6 is in multiplication here. It would divide. And y equals to 6 times 1 is 6. You're left with 3. So that would be 15. So that's 1,500. Right? So this is the increment. Y equals to rupees. No need to write it over here. You can write the units in the last step. Okay. So we have got y. Now we will substitute this y in any one of the equations to find x. Okay. So let's solve the remaining part here. Put y equals to 1500 or 1500 in any one equation. Let's use equation 1. So x plus 4y equals to 4,500. Instead of y, we are writing 1,500. Okay, and now you simplify. So 4 times 15, that is a 60. So 6,000 equals to 4,500. This should not be negative, actually. Just a minute, students. Okay, so I see the mistake here. Just a minute. It should be here when you subtract, it should be a 900. All right. So 900 divided by 6, that will give you a 1500. All right. And now when you substitute over here, when you substitute y equals to 150, this is 600 actually. All right. And then x equals to 4,500 minus 600, and that is the original pay. That is equals to 3,900. All right, so we have got x here, fine. And then the last statement or the conclusion statements, that would be, therefore, what is the original salary? That is x. Original salary equals to rupees 3,900. And the increment, or say the yearly increment, that is equals to, what is the yearly increment? Rupees 150. All right. So for word problems, get the equations. Solve it for x and y, and very important, the last step, that is you should highlight the solution. Okay, so just make sure you put these boxes for x and y, and also for the last step. Okay, let us look at the next question. This is a simple one. All right, just check, always start with whatever is asked. We are asked to find total price of 2 chairs and 2 tables. Fine. So here you can make a table for you start with chairs and tables like that. We don't know the price of one chair. Okay, so start with, let the price of one chair is equals to x, and the price of one table equals to y. Okay, now look at case 1. Case 1 says price of 3 chairs. Okay, So for three chairs, it will be 3x. And two tables, one table, this is price of one unit, okay? So price of one chair is x. So for three chairs, it is 3x. For two tables, it will be 2y. And then the total over here, the total is 4,500. Okay, this will give you the first equation. Look at it carefully. This will give you the first equation. Fine. Likewise, look at the second condition. It says price of five chairs. So here we are working on case two, five chairs. One chair is x. So five chairs will be 5x. And then three tables, that will be 3y. The total is 7,000. Okay, students, so that is how you get the table, and with the table you get the equations easily. Okay, so what are the two equations? The first one is 3x plus 2y, that is equals to 4,500, and the second is 5x plus 3y, which is equals to 7,000. Okay, look at the question carefully. We are asked to find the price of two chairs in two tables. One chair is x, so two chairs will be 2x and two tables will be 2y. So we have to find this 2x plus 2y. No need to find x separate and y separate. Straight away you need to find what is 2x plus 2y. Now how to solve this question? You can just pull out this 2, so this will be x plus y. Okay, students. So simply look at the equations. Yes, we can also solve for x and y and then substitute back to get 2x plus 2y. Okay, so name this equation 1, this is equation 2. And now we have to make any one variable same. So how do you make any one variable same? It should be, you can multiply the first equation with 3 and the second equation with 2. Or you can multiply the first equation with 5 and the second equation with 3. So this will make, this will give the x term same, or you can make the y term same. I will concentrate on y terms. Okay, so multiplying, you just state it out. What are you doing? Multiplying equation 1 with 3 and equation 2 with 2. Okay, so what will that give us? That will be 9x plus 6y equals to 2 and then equation 2, multiplying equation 2 with 2, that will be how much? I hope all of you are solving with me. Okay. That is what we get after multiplying the equations by those numbers. And now what should be done? We have to get rid of the 6. So we have to subtract. So subtracting equations. But when we are subtracting, we have to change the signs. Correct? Now changing signs, what do you get? So cross this out. You're left with 9 minus 10. That is minus x, which is equals to, now quickly just do the calculations, that is 13,500 minus 14,000. That is equals to how much, students? That will be negative 500, right? We give sign of greater number, that's 14. And negative gets crossed out. We are left with x equals to 500. Once we get x, we will find y. Okay, just remember these all are textual questions that I have taken up, and we will put x equals to 500 in any one of the equations. So put x equals to 500 in any one of the equations. You can use any one, let's say in equation 1. So that is 3x plus 2y equals to 4,500. Instead of x, we are putting 500. So 3 times 500 is 1,500. Plus 2y equals to 4,500. And now simplify, we shift this 1,500 to other side. That would be 4,500 minus 1,500, which is equals to how much, students? right? And y will be equals to how much? 3000 divided by 2, 1500. Okay, but what are we asked to find? We are asked to find 2x plus y, right? Two chairs and two tables. So that is 2x plus 2y will be equals to twice of 500 plus twice of 1500. Okay, so this will be 1000 plus this will be 3000. The total is 4000. So final answer, you should always write the final answer in the way it is asked. Total price of two chairs and two tables. Therefore, total price of two chairs and two tables is equals to rupees 4000. Okay, students, that is how you should give the conclusion. All right. Yes, this is the same question. And now we have done word problems. Let us quickly do one equation type, a question where equations are given directly, and then we will stop. So first thing you should do is write out the equations and label it. Equation 1, 3x minus y equals to 5. This is equation 2, correct? And then look at the terms. Are the x terms same or the y terms same? So here we see the y terms are same and they are with opposite signs. See, whenever the signs are opposite, straight away add, right? So adding equation 1 and 2, what do we get? 2x plus y equals to 5, 3x minus y equals to 5. We are adding the equations. So this will get crossed out. We are left with 5x equals to 10. So x equals to what? 10 divided by 5. So x equals to 2. And once you have the value of x, you can just put it in any one of the equations. So put x equals to 2 in, let's say, equation 1. That is 2x plus y equals to 5. Okay. Instead of x, I'll put brackets and rest everything is written as it is. Okay, so in place of x we have to write 2. 2 times 2 is 4. 4 plus y equals to 5. Okay, we will get rid of this 4, so that will be 5 minus 4, which is equals to 1. But always write the answer in the correct way. The solution should be written in x comma y format. So x first and then y, which is equals to 2 comma 1. Okay, that is how you should represent, presentation should go like that. All right, and how will be the marks distribution for find, for writing out these steps? These steps are very important, like adding or putting x equals to 2 in this. So all these statements, they also have marks. Okay, so make sure you are writing out all these steps correctly. And now these questions you can take up as homework. All right, there are two more. Take these two also as homework. You can take a screenshot of that. So do practice both the chapters nicely, because if you try a little harder, you will, of course, there are chances that you may get 40 out of 40 in maths 1. So all the best, students, for your exams.